Now, NBC5 First Warning Weather, the area's certified most accurate forecast.
Ben, I know that you've had this eclipse marked in your calendar for beyond 2 years. This is a big day.
Just about 7 years for me, okay. Which is the last total solar eclipse that I saw. And I knew when I was in rural Kentucky seeing that one in an August day, I knew I had to see another one. Mm. And this one's right in our backyard. So I am so excited.
Yes.
I didn't sleep at all last night. I'm going to be completely honest. But we have a little bit of a complication in the weather forecast today. We have clouds moving in this afternoon. Now, thankfully, these are high clouds, very thin. You'll still be able to see through them, but it won't be a pristine blue sky for a lot of the region. So we start the day with sun. Those clouds come in right around the total eclipse time at 3:26, and then it turns mostly cloudy for the evening. Temperatures, upper 50s, low 60s. How about that? So here's a breakdown of the cloud cover forecast. If you're looking for blue sky, maybe you're a diehard eclipse chaser or you're a professional photographer who's here to take pictures, Northeast Kingdom is your best bet. Newport to St. Johnsbury to Island Pond, excellent spot to be this afternoon. Most of the region will be dealing with those thin high clouds. Again, a little bit of a filter in the sky, but enough where you'll be able to see the partial eclipse and eventually totality if you're in the path. And farther to the west, thicker clouds coming into St. Lawrence County. So if you're in Potsdam or Messina, I might be prepared to move east to get away from some of those clouds. Maybe get closer to the Champlain Valley just to make sure you have a good view. But again, path of totality cutting through northern Vermont, northern New York, central, southern Vermont. Just so you know, you're not going to see the darkness, the sun's corona. You won't have that full experience unless you come farther to the north. So on Storm Tracker, that storm from last week is spinning over the ocean, replaced by high pressure. And behind that, the thin high clouds moving in through northern New York and eventually getting to our neck of the woods as we approach the afternoon. Again, leading up to that, we'll be in great shape with a mostly sunny sky in the morning. Temperatures starting off in the 20s and low 30s. You'll see by 11 o'clock or so, the high clouds already filling into New York. And right around eclipse time, this is 3:30, you'll see they're most dense in St. Lawrence County and the sky clearest in the Northeast Kingdom. So that is the general cloud forecast breakdown for today. I think no matter where you watch outside of those thick clouds, you'll be able to see the whole show just fine. And I hope you enjoy it today, really once in a lifetime. Clouds filling in as we look towards the overnight, breaking up again for tomorrow. Tomorrow looking like a pretty good day with partly to mostly sunny skies, highs near 60, and then a little more rain getting here for Wednesday. That kicks off an unsettled stretch of weather, which goes through the end of the week, and it culminates in this area of low pressure moving in by Friday, and it's a lot of rain that comes through. So whenever we get a situation like that, we have to watch the flooding potential. Temperatures in the 60s, a lot of snow melt, so the end of the week could be problematic, especially on some vulnerable rivers. Still several days to watch that and fine-tune the forecast. Staying mild with 50s and 60s into next week as well. Lauren?
All right, Ben, thanks.